Okay, so yeah, I made that intro a couple of weeks ago, and I don't know why exactly, I just wanted to create something retro again, but this time with an 80s VHS vibe. And it actually turned out looking a lot better than I expected, so I'm gonna show you how I did it, because that's what I do. The transitions, the effects, everything. And guys, just so you know, shooting and editing this intro in DaVinci Resolve took me just a couple of hours, and you don't even have to do any complicated color grading. I know, crazy, right? But it's true, I swear. And as usual, I would also like to encourage you to use the techniques and the tools, the effects that I'm gonna show you, to create your own intro, your own 80s look. I mean, feel free to copy this to practice, but also try to use your own creativity, okay? Okay. First thing I'm gonna show you is the effect that I used on all the clips, but it's a little bit different for each clip. But it's super easy, you'll see. First, drop an adjustment clip on your timeline so that you can use the effect for all your clips. And then, the effect is called analog damage, and you can find it here in effects, then open effects, almost all the way down, resolve effects, texture, analog damage. Just drop it on the adjustment clip, and then here in the inspector, you can adjust all the settings. Now, there's a lot of settings, and when I say a lot, I mean a lot. Of course, you can just start playing around with all these settings. It's pretty cool, actually. But for my intro, I only used 3 or 4 settings. First of all, the preset, clean VHS. For all the clips, and then depending on the clip, I played around with a few of the scan settings here, mainly image aspect, and then also H-shift, V-shift, and V-hold. See what it does? And then also all the way down here in VHS, restless foot height and offset. The restless foot height is that twitchy thing down there. And that's basically it. But like I said, there's a lot more settings, so tweak them, play around with them, customize it to create your own look. And what I also did is a fast zoom effect. Here, for example, just with keyframes, select a video clip and make sure it's a video clip and not the adjustment clip, because we don't want the analog damage effect to zoom, only the video clip. Select your clip, put the playhead where you want the zoom to start, and then here in the inspector, hit this little diamond behind zoom, move the playhead, hit the diamond again, and zoom in. And now the clip will zoom in. And if you hit this icon right here, you can see the keyframes and you can put them closer together, for example, to make the zoom go faster. Because for a sequence like this, you want everything to go fast and furious, you know? And then another effect that I used is some extra camera shake. Here in effects, just look for the camera shake, drop it onto your clip. And here, also make sure that you drop the effect on the video clip and not the adjustment clip. And I adjusted the motion scale and the motion speed. That's basically it, to make it look a little bit more realistic. But of course, again, play around with the settings, make it look like you want it to look. It's really not that difficult, right? And I know I say that a lot, but this time it's really true. Now look, I added effects like camera shake and zoom in DaVinci Resolve because it's easy, but you could of course also do them in camera. That's up to you. But there's one shot, one specific shot that gives the sequence that little bit extra oomph that you can't do in DaVinci Resolve. So you have to do it in camera. It's this one, racking focus from an object in the foreground to the subject. It looks really cool, especially once you start adding sound effects, but it's impossible to fake this in DaVinci Resolve. So, you know, even though you can do a lot in DaVinci Resolve, don't be lazy. Creating and editing an awesome sequence starts with getting good shots first. Always remember that. And then we also need some cool transitions. Now, this is where it gets interesting, because I use different layers to build each transition, like this one. So I started with a built-in DaVinci Resolve Fusion transition called Glitch. You can find it here in Effects, Transitions, Fusion Transitions, and Glitch. Drop it on a cut, and boom, you have a glitch transition. That's the base for the transitions that we're gonna build. Now, of course, you can also use it just like that. It looks pretty cool, especially when you add sound effects, but it also looks a bit basic, you know? And I wanted it to look more more. Yeah, I wanted it to look more. So what I did is I went to Storyblocks and I typed in 80s VHS static. And then you get all these cool retro overlays. And I used a few of those to elevate my transitions. But Storyblocks also has stock footage, backgrounds, and a lot more. Everything's high quality and royalty free. So you can use Storyblocks assets for YouTube and social media, but also for client work. And on top of that, with a subscription, you get unlimited downloads, which will save you a lot of money compared to those expensive paperclip models. And the most important thing, in my opinion, is that, well, it saves me a lot of time because it happens almost every week that I need a clip of something, but I don't have it. And then I use stock footage, simple. So definitely go check them out. The link is in the description. Okay, and now let me show you how I turn those overlays into a cool transition. There's nothing to it really. Just drop the overlay on your timeline, make it as long as your transition, and then set the composite mode to screen. And that's it. And it just adds a lot more texture and color to that basic transition. And for some transitions, I even added another effect. So three layers. First, the basic DaVinci Resolve glitch transition, then the Storyblocks overlay, and then I added an adjustment layer to create an effect called digital glitch. You can find it here in effects, fusion effects, digital glitch. Just drop it on the adjustment clip, and now you can actually put it wherever you want. On the transition, to make the transition even more textured, whatever. But also in the middle of a clip, if you want it to glitch for a second. See, that's what I did here. And then, for example, you can scale the video after it glitched. So, you know, be creative, guys. I can't stress it enough. If you have an idea, just go for it. If it doesn't work, no problem. Move on to the next one. That's how you learn. The music, as always, is super important. Go for something that has that 80s techie retro sound. You know, a bit of a digital sound. Video game tunes or themes or synthwave. Also sounds really good for an intro like this. Just don't go for a country and western song, obviously. And for the sound effects, I used some glitch sounds, electricity and static. Under every transition, there's some kind of glitchy static sound. Don't make it too complicated, but also don't forget it because sound effects add body to your sequence. It's called sound design for a reason, you know? Especially for something like this, 80s, retro, VHS, sound is super important. Without sound effects, this sequence, this intro sounds dead. And then the finishing touches, titles, fonts, text. I used one of DaVinci Resolve's built-in titles called Digital Glitch. Again, glitch, you know, the whole intro is glitching. And you can find it here in Effects, Titles, Digital Glitch. And the font I used is a Google font. So it's a free font, you can find it on fonts.google.com. And you can find a ton of free cool fonts there. The one I used is called Orbitron. Okay, and that's it. Yeah, the 80s, what can I say? I was born in the 80s, so it's the best decade, right? Wait, is it? Maybe for some things. Anyway, thank you so much for watching and see you in the next one.